year ago, I was passing through it. A man was there, Zacchaeus. He was the chief tax collector and was rich. He was trying to see who Jesus was, but on account of the crowd, he could not because he was short of stature. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree to see, because he was going to pass that way. When Jesus came to the place, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, hurry down, for I must stay at your house today." So he hurried down and was happy to welcome him. All who saw it began to grumble and said, "He was gone to be a guest of the one who is a sinner." Zacchaeus stood up there and said to the Lord, "Look, half of my possessions, Lord, I will give to the poor. And if I have defrauded anyone of anything, I will pay it back four times as much." Then Jesus said to him, "Today, salvation has come to this house, because he too is the son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek out and save the lost." Thus ends the gospel.
Let me pray once more. Gracious God, be with me as we share in the words of your servants who model the way for faith. Thank you, dear one, for this opportunity. I'm going to focus on the Zacchaeus story today. I grew up, how many people know the Zacchaeus song? Oh, wow. You don't all know the Zacchaeus song? Would you like to sing it? I think we should sing it.
Zacchaeus was a
small man to one of large faith. There he was. He was a tax collector. A lot of folk didn't care much for this tax collector because he was one of their own, but he was working for the oppressing government, and he was doing their duty by collecting taxes, and he was getting paid off the taxes he raised from his own people. Kind of a tough place to be. You go to a dinner party, he's not the one you want to sit next to. You appear in public, you don't want to be standing next to him to have the cameras catch you. You want to go somewhere, and he's the one, if you see him coming, you probably turn and talk to someone else or walk the other way. Zacchaeus. Well, Zacchaeus has been hearing about this one called Jesus. This one who was teaching, this one who was preaching, this one who was going from town to town, village to village, and people just could not get enough of him. We live in a time where I've had enough of some people, but they could not get enough of Jesus. And he hears that he's coming his way, and he gets there, and the crowd is 4, 5, 6 people deep, and he's short, and he can't get it. My mother was 4'11". Deborah would tease her when we were in the kitchen, and my mother would say, "Can I be of any help?" And Deborah would say, "Well, can you get that thing on the top shelf?" Well, no, she couldn't. But she had a good sense of humor. But there were limitations as to what she could do and how far she could reach. And that's the way it was with Zacchaeus. So I guess there he sees the crowd, and he wants to see Jesus, and he pulls himself up into a tree, and he looks down. Now, I feel that that in itself was an act of faith, and allowed him, he is out there in front of everyone. Now, some are saying, look at that fool in the tree. Look at that Zacchaeus, what's he doing here? Look at him, wow, how dare he? How dare he? He heard Jesus, and he wants to be closer. He wants to find out for himself if it's true, if it's right, is there goodness here? Is there some other force, some other ability, some other awareness that I can attach myself to? That I can say of him, I believe and I will follow? That's what he says when he steps up in that tree. That in itself puts him out there in front of everyone. And it is an act of faith. He's not aware quite yet how big an act of faith it is. He's just wanting to see. He's wanting to hear. He's wanting whatever little bit he could get from this Holy One to influence him, even from afar. Crowds yell. Crowd shout. Jesus and the disciples are coming through. And Jesus looks beyond all other people. Jesus looks for the goodness with us all. Jesus has desires for us all to be as good as we might and as faithful as we possibly could become. And he looks up and he sees this man in a tree. Perhaps precariously hanging from him, but holding on for sure because he knew he was in for something good. Then he says, "Zacchaeus, come down. I'm with you, dude. I'm in your house." His dinner ready. His dinner ready. Dinner has more to do with is more than just the ingredients of putting everything together. The placemats, napkins, cutlery, silverware, plates, pitchers, and serving bowls. They're all just little parts of what's being accomplished as a family gathers for dinner. And there, they go to Zacchaeus' home.
this house. Why would he come with this man? We wouldn't. And that's precisely the reason that Jesus goes. Because the rest of them wouldn't. And he shows to the world around him that faith comes from a variety of ways. The kingdom is built on a variety of personalities and perspectives. And here is one to be included in the kingdom's work. Oh, perhaps he has sent someone on the heavens to make sure there's enough to eat, get it all out, get out the best wine, the best of everything, because this one is coming. After dinner, Zacchaeus is so overwhelmed. Not simply because Jesus is there, but about how Jesus is in the process of changing his life. And he talks about giving back all that he's taken he should have not taken. If I've wronged anyone, I'll pay them back four times what I've wronged them. I'll give half of what I have for your kingdom's goodness. And on this day, a meal was not accomplished, but a dedicated life is found. Today is our Commitment Sunday. Hopefully you've received a couple of letters, an intention to give the donate card, an estimate of giving card. If you haven't, there are some of these. And today, before we eat, we don't know what's for dinner, but I know it'll be grand because Jesus calls us. Before we go from here, we're all going to make an act of dedication. We're going to take one of these cards and we're going to fill it in. Not just to put a number down, but to say somehow to the saving one, this is what I commit to you. This is what I will give to you. On the back of the card are opportunities for service, for us to participate. We not only give up our treasure, we give up our time, we give up our energies. Our denomination and many churches and many denominations are now on what's called a mission first perspective. What will you bring to the table so that all of God's own leads? What will you bring to the table so that there will be ample for everyone? What will you bring to the table so that this congregation might be able to continue in the significant ministries? A safe haven, a support of children, a support of folk who are shut in, a support of programs that are enriching lives and changing lives, a support of a wonderful program within our congregation that's filled with education, filled with wonderful music, filled with opportunities to come together in sweet, sweet fellowship. We're not just dedicating a number. We've got a mailman and a phone man. What we're doing is dedicating ourselves to Christ for the work that we will do within this congregation. As our offering is received, we're going to ask you to place your offering as well as your intention of giving part in the offering tray. And it'll be later on after that, you would have an act of blessing and commitment as we share together in our journey for being Christ's home. Zacchaeus, small man, some folks thought of worth that much. Comes and has dinner with Jesus.
becomes one of the most generous individuals